We just got the roll center adjusters installed, and initially we had some rubbing against the wheel. The lower control arm would be rubbing against the wheel, basically the inner part of the wheel, and we had to trim it, shave off the control arm, and 3 turns higher. So the ride height's actually perfect now. It's still lower in the front a little bit, and it's just, I think, perfect now. Wow, look at that. So we're gonna go for a test drive and see what it feels like with the roll center adjusters. Wow. Okay. Oh, I can see the Bunta air freshener. It smells so good.
Drive.
Tug a car. So good. Oh my god. Woo. That was fun.
Oh yeah. I just literally
I didn't even go all out.
Yeah.
But that was a nice safe drive. Woo! So good. It's fogging up. Like my heel toe douches. Oh my god, it's so good now. It's crazy. Oh god. I didn't do much talking, but hopefully the video can show like how nimble and how well the car handles now. It's so planted. You don't feel that much body roll. Even though we're on really soft springs. Okay. All right, so we just installed coilovers. Well, we already had coilovers, but now we have 7 kilogram springs instead of, what was it, four up front, and 6 kilograms in the rear. And we're gonna go on a test drive. So here we go. Bumps, it actually doesn't feel that stiff. I think it's because the previous ones I had extra stiff dampers or something. But this one rides really nice. Right? It's not bumpy at all.
Yeah.
It's so smooth. Too stiff at all. I was afraid it's gonna be too stiff. Oh, and also now it's Swiss springs all around. Before we only had Swiss springs up front, and now we have Swiss all around.
Just a few moments go through.
body roll. It's so good now. 7's perfect. 7's perfect. 7, 5 is good too if you're doing some daily driving. Which, yeah, Jenny's car does do some. Actually, a lot of daily driving. Wow. Oh, now you really feel the stiffness. Maybe it's like breaking in, settling.
Yeah.
Now these bumps feel a little more stiff than before. But still really, really soft still.
Yeah.
It's not as...
It's crazy.
Yeah. And sometimes on the highway, it feels different because you're going faster. So even the small bumps, you'll feel like you're flying up in the seat.
Yeah.
It bounces you around. So let's see how that feels on the highway. Wow. I'm so glad I got these.
Yeah,
but I had to spend twice the money.
Yeah.
I had to.
They didn't have it at first.
Yeah, they didn't have it at first. But then, so, right when Jenny was getting hers, we realized they actually do offer it in
higher
spring rates. So I was like, oh my gosh, I have to get it. So if anyone's looking for a set of nearly new BC racing coilovers with 4 and 3 kilogram springs,
contact us.
Oh, it's getting hot. Shooting ranges. But Keisuke said that, remember he said, it's the ultimate disgrace for a racer is to be beaten by a lowered powered car.
Yeah.
Right? So.
Yeah.
And it's really true because in the racing world, we talk about momentum cars. Those are cars that are lower on power.
Mm-hmm.
But it forces you to carry your speed. To maintain your momentum through the turns, to not over slow the car more than you have to, and you're just extracting every bit of speed out of it, and it makes you a faster driver, makes you more aware of the potential of the car through the corners, because you really want to extract every bit of speed out of the corner. That's why they're so rewarding, so fun to drive. Just like this morning, it was so fun because like you could feel the power building up, right? Like in an electric car, you feel the instant power, but there's a certain joy to feeling that power slowly build up. You know what I mean? Like it just feels so good. Rather than just bam and you're just there and there's and it's over. That's why these cars are so fun. You're revving all the way up, extracting all the power that you can out of it. Listen to that sound. Oh my god. It sounds so good. It's gonna sound even better when I get the B pipe. I don't know when it's coming. I've been waiting nearly half a year for it. Half a year, wow. Yeah, it's coming from Japan. Spoon Racing. If you don't know, Spoon is like the what? It's like, how should I say it? The ultimate Honda tuner?
Yeah.
Or at least in Japan. It's just so fun. Yeah, people don't know what they're missing out when they focus too much on the car's power and numbers and or just simply focusing on the car itself because it's all about the driving. There's a lot of other Honda companies in the States, you know, they might, but it just doesn't get cooler than Spoon as a Honda fan.
Is the reason the founder of Spoon had Spoon because he loved Honda so much too?
Yeah, that's awesome. Wow, look at that. Have some really good stuff like their rigid collars because
they're just focusing on like the suspension, like the
I like their philosophy, like their parts. Sometimes you'll see that parts don't even add power. like or they have these parts that are just so simple, and but of course their race cars go through much more work, and their actual race cars that make that actually perform, but a lot of their parts, one can argue that, you know, there might be better options out there. But it's, oh my god, I don't know how to express it. It's just, it's Spoon, right? Go watch Donut Media's video on Spoon. Yeah. Wow, it feels good.
Yeah.
I love it so much.